राजेंद्र, दिस इज संतोष फ्रॉम कर्नल स्पेयर टेक्नोलॉजी. आर यू एबल टू लिसन मी राइट?
Yeah.
ओके, सो जस्ट वी आर डिस्कसिंग टुडे व्हाई वीआईओ इंट्रोडक्शन डेमो, व्हाई वीआईओ इज रिक्वायर्ड इन आवर एनवायरनमेंट. बिफोर दैट आई जस्ट वांट टू इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ. आई एम ए रियल टाइम फैकल्टी and having 8 years of experience in multiple domains. So on the Windows domain and the Linux domain and AIX domain. So the prerequisite for this VIO, are you working on any AIX? So we will discuss today what is the VIO actually. Why the VIO is required? What we can perform after going through this demo class, we will be able to understand, list the reason for implementing the virtual IO, describe the implementation of virtual IO, install and configuration, the small part I will take, configure partition to use virtual devices, what is virtual Ethernet, shared Ethernet adapter, virtual SCSI, and virtual object devices. And we will describe the virtual optical device backed by a file. So I will start it now. What is virtual IO? Sharing physical resources. Why sharing the physical resources between partitions? So virtually, what we are sharing, we are sharing the physical resources in between multiple logical partitions. So what is logical partitions? On physical servers, on standalone server, we can create multiple logical partitions. So in that partitions, I can create a virtual adapter and I can assign to multiple partitions. Virtual IO functionality, it is available on Power 5, Power 6 processor based system. It is licensed software. Virtual IO client partition may be running AX 5.3, AX 6.1 or Linux server, driven by partitions. Power 5 and Power 6 architecture supports up to 254 partitions. So what is Power 5 and Power 6? You know?
Yeah, I know. Power 6 is
okay. So you know the concept of LPAP, logical partition?
No, I don't know.
See, what is logical partition? On my physical box, consider you have standalone server. On that standalone server, you have memory, CPU, and IO devices. Right? For server purpose, you require memory, CPU, and IO. If you have a physical server, physical hardware, that hardware you can dedicatedly using for only one server for hosting. Right? So, creating the partitions, logical partitions, on the same hardware, we can create multiple servers using the physical resources. So that is called LPAR, logical partitioning. So what is the benefit of LPAR? The benefit of LPAR is I can use the same hardware for multiple servers. On that server, I can install database, I can install application, I can put some of the servers in production, some of the servers in testing environment. Okay. So, I don't need to purchase individual server for my application, individual servers for my database. So, this is the benefit of having LPAR. So, again, LPAR, what is required? For each LPAR, you require dedicated processor, RAM, and dedicated IOs. In IOs, for IOs, you require one IO for Ethernet and one IO for disk. So, still, my IO cost I am not able to minimize, right? I need to invest for IO. For Ethernet card, I need to pay for around 2 lakhs. And for disk IO, I need to pay for 2.5 lakhs. So, but what space I have minimized, right? So, I can create multiple server on single physical box. So, the micro part, it is the benefit of VIO that physical resources I can emulate as a virtual and I can use it on multiple LPAR. So how it is happening, we will discuss. Hello?
I can hear you. I just kept mute because you should not listen any kind of disturbance.
Okay. No problem. So, what is driven by the partition? Power 5 and Power 6 architecture supports up to 254 partitions. So, I can create 256 partition if I have a Power 6 and Power 5 machine. Hardware supports more partition than there are PCI slots to support them. Slot become limiting factor, right? For example, each partition require at least minimum one slot for boot disk, one slot for Ethernet adapter. So, system example, a fully configured P5570 supports up to 160 partitions. So, on a fully 560 P5570 server, I can create 160 partitions. So, physically, I can say it is like a standalone 160 servers. So, 160 applications or 160 databases I can have. Supports up to 160 PCIX slots. Not enough for all 160 partition without using virtual devices. So, PCI slot I can use dedicatedly. So, what is the benefit of virtual I/O? Partition can be created without required additional physical I/O resource. So, if I don't have virtualization, so for each helper I required one dedicated disk adapter and one dedicated network adapter. So, for 160, if I am creating 160 helper in P5570, then I require that much of disk adapter and that much of network adapter. So, my cost will be, what I can do, I will go for virtual I/O and the physical adapters, I will make it as a virtual. So, how economical I/O modules, efficient utilization of resources through sharing. So, that physical adapter I will shared with my 170 or 160 servers. Facilities server consolidation allow client attachment to previously unsupported storage solution. Virtual device overview, virtual devices. What I can do, I can virtualize virtual SCSI. Virtual I/O server partition uses file, logical volumes, whole disk or optical device to provide the backing storage for virtual SCSI devices presented to client partition. Client C as a disk or a CD. So, what is the benefit? Whatever the physical resources I will assign to my virtual server, one partition I will create, and I will install one virtual server on that helper, and whatever the physical cards I will assign to my virtual I/O server. So, from virtual I/O servers, I will create some virtual Ethernet adapter and virtual SCSI adapter, and I will map that adapter with my virtual I/O server, and that adapter I will assign to my clients. So, all the physical resources, it is on my virtual I/O server. Through virtual I/O server, I will map that physical resources to my client. So, no need to purchase the dedicated physical I/Os for my client. So, through the virtual, I am sharing that resources to my clients. Virtual Ethernet do not need virtual I/O server. Partitions on the same system communicate without using physical Ethernet adapter. So, even I can virtualize my Ethernet adapter also. Shared Ethernet adapter, and there is one concept IVE, Integrated Virtual Ethernet. If you are using Power 6 machine, you will get one Ethernet adapter with IVE, Integrated Virtual Ethernet. Through that, you can virtualize that Integrated Virtual Ethernet adapter, and we can assign that Ethernet adapter to 16 helper. So, I don't need to purchase dedicated physical Ethernet adapter for each helper. Shared Ethernet adapter, if you don't have a IVE options, so you can go for shared Ethernet adapter. What is shared Ethernet adapter? To my helper, it is virtual adapter, and virtual adapter, it directly cannot communicate to outside world. So in that case, I require to create a bridge on my VIO server so that my virtual clients or virtual helpers can communicate with my outside world. So that is what Save Dependency Adapter, and it is layer 2 bridge. Integrated Virtual Ethernet Adapter provides similar function to Virtual Ethernet Adapter. Partition can communicate with external physical network without going through a shared Ethernet adapter. If you have a IVE or Integrated Virtual Ethernet, you don't need to buy virtual IO server. Why? Because it is inbuilt virtualization in Integrated Virtual Ethernet that you can map with 16 helper. So what is virtual LAN? Virtual LAN establish virtual network segment on top of physical switch devices. Virtual and dedicated network device can be used simultaneously for communication. So VLAN is described by IEEE 802.1 standard. So what I am doing on the physical card, on the physical switch devices, establish virtual network segment on the top of physical switch devices, and that physical switch with the help of shared Ethernet adapter will communicate with my internal helpers. So IEEE 802.1Q, it is a VLAN. Some of the host will be VLAN aware and some of the host will not be VLAN aware. That is called VLAN unaware host. That means if your host is VLAN aware, that will put the VLAN ID in packet and transfer to respective switch. If your host is not VLAN aware host, then the switch will accept that packet and will tag that packet with the respective VLAN and transfer it to outside world. We will cover this concept when we learn the VIO actually. IEEE 802.1Q VLAN, Ethernet packets are tagged with their VLAN membership information. Ethernet switch restrict delivery to member of that VLAN. The VID can be added to an Ethernet packet either by VLAN aware host. The switch in the case of VLAN unaware host. See, VLAN aware host, the host itself will tag the VLAN ID in their packet and transmit it to outside world. Recommendation: single network per adapter, use untagged port and PVID. Multiple network per adapter, use VID. That is the recommendation while using the VIO. Virtual Ethernet overview. What is virtual? Enable inter-partition communication without the need for physical network adapter assigned to each partition. Adapter are virtual, and if communication is only between partition on the same managed system, no physical Ethernet adapter is needed. Require Power 5 or Power 6 processor based system and HMC or IOM for configuration. Partition can run either AX5.3, AX6.1 or Linux. Does not require the purchase of any additional feature or software such as the PowerVM edition feature. So what is virtual Ethernet overview? Suppose you have a virtualization license, so physical resources you can shared with your logical partition. Consider this is my VIO server and these are my helpers. In one physical box I have created multiple helpers. This is my helper 1, helper 2, helper 3, helper 4, helper 5. If you have virtualization license, so consider you have not virtualization license. So for each LPAR you require dedicated network Ethernet adapter, dedicated disk adapter, either it will be FC adapter or ISCSI adapter, depend on your storage, what your storage you are using. For each LPAR I require dedicated adapter. So my cost will go high. So what is the solution? Solution is go for the virtualization. So what is the benefit of virtualization? Instead of using physical adapter, I will use virtual adapter. So all the physical resources I will assign to my VIO server and I will create the virtual adapter on respective LPAR. Respective LPARs I will create, and all this virtual will communicate through my VIO. Consider this is my Ethernet. So this Ethernet I cannot talk with the outside world directly to my physical switch. So what is required? I need to create one bridge on my VIO server. What is the bridge? Bridge will combine my physical adapter and my virtual adapter, and it will create one bridge. Again, one virtual adapter will create. Through that virtual adapter, I can reach to my external switch. So from outside, this helper will be accessible. This is the virtual Ethernet overview. Up to 256 virtual Ethernet adapter supported per partition. So per partitions, I can create 256 virtual adapter. And support for large MTU size also supported. Support both IP version 4 and IP version 6 standard. My virtual adapter will support IP version 4 as well as IP version 6 standard. Virtual Ethernet adapter with only a PVID is configured just like a physical Ethernet adapter. It's work as like a physical Ethernet adapter. So how it is a virtual, but for my OS, in my OS it is act like a physical Ethernet adapter. Virtual Ethernet adapter with multiple VID is configured as a VLAN device with tagging. So multiple VLAN you can add on the top of your virtual Ethernet adapter, that is also supported. Virtual Ethernet overview. See, this is my VIO server and these are my LPARs. So what is the virtual Ethernet? Through the hypervisor I can communicate within my frame, not outside the frame. So I can communicate with Linux host AX host can communicate with Linux host, this AX host can communicate with this AX host, but not outside the world. So allow partition to communicate without using physical Ethernet adapter. So if you have created the virtual adapter on respective LPAR, so you can communicate within the frame without physical Ethernet adapter. Why? That communication is happening through the power hypervisor. Power hypervisor Ethernet switch. So power hypervisor implement a software Ethernet switch. In my power hypervisor I am creating one software based Ethernet switch. All this communication will will happen through the power hypervisor. Power hypervisor and consistent with IEEE 802.1Q supports up to 4094 network VLAN IDs. My power hyper switch supports 4094 networks and VLAN IDs. Uses PVID tag for untagged packets. If your AirPAR is sending untagged packets, so my power hyper switch will tag that packet will and send with respective AirPARs inside my frame. So copies packet between partition memory to memory. So taking, if suppose assume that this partition want to communicate with this partition, so it will create one packet and will send to the respective switch. The switch will check that packet from which it is coming and it will tag the VLAN ID to that packet, and switch again will look for the destination IP or destination MAC address and will transfer this packet to the respective host. But it is through memory to memory only, because power hypervisor, when you start your LPAR will start with the help of power hypervisor. So you are sending the packet from one host to another host through power hypervisor memory. So copies packet between partitions memory to memory only, include with all power 5 and power 6 processor based system. It is available in power 5 and power 6 system and newly on power 7 and power 8 also. Does not require any power VM addition feature. If you want to internal communication only, LPAR to LPAR, that not required to be power VM addition feature. What is virtual Ethernet adapter? Virtual Ethernet adapters are required to access the hypervisor Ethernet switch. So, to access the hypervisor Ethernet switch, you require to create a virtual Ethernet adapter on each LPAR. So, how you will create that adapter? Use HMC to create virtual adapter. Create in partition profile or dynamically. You can go on partition profile and directly you can create the virtual Ethernet adapter and assign to particular LPAR, or dynamically you can create the virtual Ethernet adapter and assign to the respective LPAR. So there you are creating that with the help of HMC. So what HMC will do while creating? HMC will generate MAC address, and that MAC address it will assign to respective Ethernet adapter, respective virtual Ethernet adapter. Local bit to prevent conflict with physical Ethernet adapter, and based on machine serial number for uniqueness. So based on serial LPAR serial number, your HMC will generate the MAC address and will assign to respective Ethernet adapter. Access to 20 VLAN network per adapter. So each adapter it can access the 20 VLAN network per adapter. So each my virtual Ethernet adapter it will communicate with 20 VLAN adapters or 20 different VLANs. This is the benefits of having virtual Ethernet adapter. Creating virtual Ethernet, how I will create? So I will go on respective LPAR profile and I will create the virtual Ethernet adapter. This is the profile of my LPAR, respective LPAR. I will go on that and I will create the virtual Ethernet adapter. So I will assign the virtual switch through which my virtual Ethernet adapter will communicate. I will assign the VLAN ID for my virtual Ethernet adapter. If additional VLAN IDs are required, so I will select this optional setting and will add additional VLAN IDs. to communicate with the different VLANs. So this is the beauty of my virtual Ethernet adapter. So this is the virtual adapters. Through the actions, I will create the virtual adapters. So in my operating system, in my AIX, my virtual Ethernet adapter will look like as a physical Ethernet adapter. See, ENT0 and ENT1, it will look like as a physical Ethernet adapter. There is no, only the difference is it is virtual instead of physical. So on the top of my virtual Ethernet adapter, I can assign the IP addresses. Adding VLAN access, if you require additional VLAN, you can add as we discuss. So on how to, you can add from the OS side also. VLAN configuration examples, this is the examples given for VLAN configuration. Up to 20 VLANs I can add on single virtual Ethernet adapter, and I can map to my LPAR. But LPAR, it will communicate with 20 different VLANs. So this is the benefit of having virtual Ethernet adapter. But what is the virtual IO server? Virtual IO server it is software installed on the LPAR. It is a one kind of operating system that will communicate with my virtual devices. Virtual in the sense my virtual Ethernet adapter and virtual FC cards. If I map a disk from my virtual IO server, it will be visible as a disk on my client. So if I have a Power VM license, so as I have discussed, if you have Power VM license, and what you can do, you can create one LPAR as a VIO, virtual IO server. So